Look at this, man. Here we go.
Can't disclose the information. GDPR.
Cool. Look at that, Mr. Leon, Mrs. Caitlin, Mr. Joe, you gorgeous monkey. These are just a few of the gorgeous bits of ML merchandise heading off to you lovelies today. Bit of an update vlog today. We're not going to be doing a huge amount of car stuff because I've got loads of little bits and bobs to go and do. First port of call is dropping these goodies off to the post office. I'm actually going to be doing my pre-release on my first ever hoodie. I actually changed my mind. I decided to do a classic ML hoodie first to try and carry on with the sort of classic theme with the t-shirts. And yeah, I'll be doing the pre-release probably next week, if not the start of the week after. I'll put a little link here to my website if you want to check out the stuff I've currently got available. Feel free. Also, feel free to give the video a like. If you do watch my videos and you don't sort of regularly give them likes, make sure you do. It would be really appreciated. Massive, massive shout out to these guys who just joined up on Patreon. We've got Chris Newton, Kieran Schmidt, who's also buying my T-Sport Powerflow exhaust, that's pretty cool. We've got Will Stonehouse, we've got Niall, Thomas Napton, Jordan Eskate, and Richard Clayzy. You guys are absolute legends. Massive, massive thanks for joining up. On Patreon, we've got a cool little ML community. You can get early access to all the videos. I hold regular weekly competitions where I give away sort of signed memorabilia. I've actually got a private Monkey London Discord, which you can gain access to once you join up on Patreon. And there's loads of people on there. We're constantly talking about cars, about monkey videos, about Assetto Corsa. Yeah, needless to say, we do have a pretty cool community. So if you would like direct contact with me and you want to kind of help support the channel and get behind it, a lot of you guys will know that I don't really kind of appease the YouTube algorithm. So I don't make a massive amount off YouTube. So I really do need the patrons to kind of keep the channel going. And yeah, I'll chuck the Patreon out down here. If you want to check it out, feel free. And hopefully I can chat to a few of you guys on there. Right, we have arrived at the post office.
A few moments later.
Post office for a mighty fine service. I've also got key rings coming out that I'm making with cage laser. They're gonna be 3D cut in aluminium. They're gonna be laser etched with like Monkey London designs. As well as that, we've got new stickers coming out, new sun strips. I've got my hats, which are inbound now. Yeah, lots of stuff coming out. But yeah, if there's anything else you'd particularly like to see, feel free to let me know in the comment section. See if I can just get out of here without killing anybody. Tomorrow is a super, super exciting day. George and I are gonna be heading up to see the guys at Fensport to start the Toyota Corolla 2ZZGE conversion. Fensport are massively famous. A lot of you sort of older guys might remember them probably from like the back in the Max Power days. They used to have some of the fastest Toyotas in the UK and I believe in Europe back in the time. Adrian, the owner, had a very synonymous Toyota Corolla running a GT4 running gear, so Celica GT4 ST205. And I believe it was doing like quarter miles in about 10 seconds and it did 200 miles an hour. Wow. These guys are really a bit of a sort of hidden British gem. They used to be a bit more in the spotlight back in the days, but yeah, these days they kind of keep themselves to themselves, but they're still building some absolutely mental cars.
This is the Fensport Corolla. Its 2-litre turbocharged engine develops 700 horsepower. It's taken £35,000 of parts and 3 years of effort to develop. But earlier this year, this unassuming little car managed an official 200.4 miles an hour.
Holy smoke, look at that Corolla go, man. He just shot off the line like he was in a catapult.
Luckily for me, they're very kindly getting involved with Georgie's Corolla. Massive, massive props to them. They're being absolute stars doing this for us. Once Fensport are finished on their side, we're going to be sending the car to ECU Master to get the loom and the ECU all installed. And then once that's done, back to Fensport, get it mapped. Tom's going to set up all the sort of tuning parameters, get it driving nice on the road. Then we'll probably take it back to ECU Master, stick it on the dyno, and see what sort of power she makes. I've actually got the JZX on board in the Brian James trailer now, so I'm going to head up to Scouse's. He's very kindly going to hold on to the car tomorrow whilst we're at Fensport, and then Thursday I'll be picking it back up and taking it off to ECU Master to get the full ECU Master Black installed. We'll chill out at the farm for a little bit, check out what the guys are up to, offload the JZX, and then once the trailer's free, I'll pop back a little bit later on and I'll pick up the Corolla T-Sport and chuck that in the back. I will see you guys up at the farm in a bit. Cheers. Oh, look at that, everybody. Sick Nissan Silvia S15 Varietta, and that, yes, was my phone just dropping on the floor. Pretty cool, man. Look at that, baby.
Carson Performance.
Where's my favourite ginger? Lewis, you sex bomb. Hello, Mitto. Look at this, man. One of Scouse's customers called Charlotte. Pretty, pretty cool. If you've never seen one of these before, this is actually an S15 convertible, which is really, really rare. These are actually all automatic, and Scouse tells me this is actually in for a manual conversion. So Charlotte is getting rid of the auto box and getting a stick shift instead. Quite a tidy car, to be fair. Needs a little bit of paint and stuff on the roof, but overall, it is actually really, really clean, this car. Pretty cool that in the summer, roof down, couple of chicks in the back.
Where's Merz?
Nom nom.
We've got Mr. Gareth's car back in the workshop. What are you boys doing, man? Gareth's SR was actually fine, but he's doing a V8 conversion?
Yeah, V8 swap. Yeah.
What's that, one UZ?
One UZ, and then maybe go turbo eventually.
Oh, crazy, man. What is the power of a stock one UZ? Is it like 250 or something?
Yeah. Around that kind of area, yeah. Yeah. I don't know how much is lost over time, but it may have been like that in the factory.
But they've got decent torque, to be fair, which is where it sort of makes up for it.
Yeah, I mean, for this, because this is a more show car, it's more about the looks and the sound. And the noise. Mainly the sound. I mean, yeah. They do sound good, one UZ.
But even with the stock one, I've driven an IS200 with the stock one UZ, and it still went decent, man.
Oh yeah, they've got some fun. Yeah,
it does go. So what are you boys doing now? Just pretty much engine's been taken out, and now you're
basically
just hiding
bay.
It all up.
Yeah, we stripped the engine bay, we're basically just putting all the bits in there ready for Lozzy to come and collect it.
Sweet, man. What are you doing with it? Muzzy's got his eyes on it already.
Yeah, it's coming down to my unit.
Muzzy's having the engine. Charlotte, the Varietta, is having the gearbox conversion.
Perfect.
She's having all the manual stuff.
Mr. Scouse is just busy taking off all the sort of gearbox ancillaries for Charlotte's Varietta conversion. Very cool. Mm-hmm. Mr. Mitto.
Hi.
You always have lots of interesting stuff to tell us. I can see you have now affixed lots of sort of masking apparatus.
Well, it's taken me so long and the boys are making that much fun of me, I thought I'd wrap it for Christmas. Basically, we're under sealing it, so I've chopped all this off, rust treated it, red oxided it, so it's all like, you know, prepped and treated the whole thing, really, so it won't rust. Sealed. Yeah. There's not a lot in the way of sound deadening in this car at all, so it'll probably make it a bit nicer than it was to drive before like in terms of noise.
You, you found there was quite a lot of resonance inside and stuff?
The only noise of it was the roof, really, because like it's just nothing there. You can see where the line's all messed up, everything below that line is going to be black.
Yep.
So it'll all be like stone chip black. Obviously, the bottom of the bay, like, it doesn't need to be that fancy because you're not really looking at it
much.
Yeah,
you can't see it, yeah.
And then we're going to come all the way out to the outer sill, mess up here, because obviously the normal car, you'd see this, but because I've got a body kit for it, you don't see it. So it might as well be sealed and protected. The previous owner had drilled some holes in here, so the underseal will clog them up and block it all up anyway. So
cool, man. If you guys look here, you can kind of see where the original fenders would have gone, and that's kind of where Mitto and Co have kind of cut out to give them that extra clearance. But obviously, once you put your over fenders on, you won't see.
No, it's back to being looking beautiful. The whole purpose of this is just to make a car that, like, as near as damn it to brand new as you can get. So it's all fresh paint inside, it'll be all fresh underseal on the underside, but properly, you know, with a completely stripped shell.
Yeah.
Which should be good for years to come.
Where's Scousey?
He's gone to the doctor's.
What's wrong with him? Penis enlargement.
Yeah.
Brian James looking absolutely spiffing as always. Here we go. Ta-da! Amazing how big this car is, isn't it? It literally consumes the entire trailer.
It's a big boy, yeah.
At the moment, we haven't actually got things like the side skirts on or the front bumper, which should make getting out of the trailer, relatively speaking, quite easy. What's up, Lozzy? Oh, hello, sausage. Quick little look down the sides as well. So this is the 2.1 meter bed width. It's the widest race sport they do. And that's how much clearance you have either side, even with a JZX. Not forgetting this has massive over fenders on it, front and back, and it's also got 10.5 inch rims all the way around. So you're not really gonna get any wider than this. Oi, oi, what's up, Mishka? Today we have Boris London.
Hi, viewers.
Looking very gorgeous today.
It is very cold out here.
Don't forget, Mr. Lozzy Bear gonna chuck his diesels down here if you need any
transport needs, give them a shout.
Next up, I'm just going to start undoing all of the straps on the JZX.
Here we have the local T-boy from DSI.
Next up, I'm actually going to be using my electric winch on the old BJT, so it's very simple to use. You've got your little remote control here. You connect that little wire into the main unit there, and that is pretty much it. Obviously, make sure your car is not in gear, and then handbrake off. That's a little look of the interior at the moment.
We are on a little bit of a hill, so in a sec, the lad's just going to help me push the first little bit, then we can use the winch to get her down.
Thank you, Mr. Loz.
Absolute legend cameraman.
That is the car on the ground. We haven't actually seen it in the daylight yet. Just bear in mind the paint is obviously quite messy at the moment. Dave's going to be sorting out a few more bits on it.
So all the door cards in the daylight looking pimp.
HDF roll cage looking beautiful as always. We haven't actually affixed this bride's passenger seat yet. We will do that at some point. We're also going to be getting a new dashboard as well, because this dash already had a few cracks in it and stuff, so we will look at getting a new dash. Yeah, that is the car as she stands in the daylight. This is the Cage Laser bumper bar, which I showed you guys in the previous episode. We've obviously got the dash bar, which they've added additionally as well. We've got all the door cards, and then under here we've got the jacking bar, which you can just about see through there. So the idea is you just get a jack on that little point there and jack the car up, rather than jacking it up on the diff, which is quite the way down there on a JZX.
Like I mentioned in the video, the boys are going to be storing the JZX for me tomorrow, and then on Thursday we're going to be picking it up once we finish with the guys at Fensport. What are you doing, Lozzy Bear?
Well, we are taking Gareth's S14 back to its hideout. Can't disclose the information. GDPR.
We've also got another white S14 here.
Just a service and a compression test. We'll do the compression test first and then we'll see if it needs service. Yeah.
Look at the rims, very purple. You guys obviously saw the PS13 in the previous episode, and Lou's car is starting to look really, really nice as well.
I noticed a few of you guys in the comment section as well were asking about this Mark 1 Golf convertible, which is actually owned by a friend of mine called James, known him for a long, long time. I'm hoping that one day Mrs. Monk and I might actually be able to buy this, because we have sort of shown a bit of an interest. At the moment, I think it's got a 1.8T in it, which I've sort of said to James is more than enough power, but he has sort of said he wants to put a different engine in there.
We're double vlogging, man.
It's a vlog inception.
So if you ever wanted to know what Missa looks like vlogging, that's it.
Before we close off today's cheeky little vlog, tomorrow I'm off to Fensport, but you're off to see Dave, DY Engines.
DY, yeah, we're very busy boys.
Lots more goodness coming up with this, man.
Oh. Hi, thanks.
Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this cheeky little vlog. Sorry there wasn't a huge amount of sort of mechanical stuff or driving going on today, but sometimes we need to do a bit of transportation and logistics. So lots of love from me, lots of love from these lovelies, and we'll see you guys soon.